In the previous module, we characterized maximal ideals M of a commutative ring R as the ideals such that R by M is a field. In this module, we will characterize the ideals P of a commutative ring R such that R by P is an integral domain. Also, in this module, we show that the class of all maximal ideals is a subclass of the class of all prime ideals. Prime ideals are one of the fundamental notions in ring theory, especially in the commutative ring theory. That is why I would like to give here the general definition of a prime ideal. And after this definition, we will prove an equivalent characterization of the prime ideals, which is valid for commutative rings with 1. Here we give the definition as follows. A proper ideal P of R is said to be a prime ideal if for any two ideals I and J of R, their product IJ is subset of P implies that either I is a subset of P or J is a subset of P. First of all, we prove the following equivalent characterization. Suppose R is a commutative ring with 1 and P is a proper ideal of R, then P is prime if and only if for all AB belongs to R, AB belongs to P implies that either A belongs to P or B belongs to P. First, assume that P is a prime ideal of R and AB are two elements of R such that their product AB is in P. We are to show that either A is in P or B is in P. For this, consider ideals I to be the ideal generated by A and denote the ideal generated by B by J. Then their product IJ is a subset of the ideal generated by AB. Now, since AB is an element of P, this ideal generated by AB is a subset of P, and hence the product of the ideals I and J, IJ is a subset of P. And since P is prime, it follows that either the ideal I is a subset of P or J is a subset of P. Since A belongs to I and B belongs to J, so it follows that either A is in P or B is in P. For the converse, assume that P satisfies the given condition and consider two ideals IJ of R such that their product is a subset of P. We are to show that either I is a subset of P or J is a subset of P. If I is a subset of P, we have done. Suppose that I is not a subset of P, we show that J is a subset of P. Since I is not a subset of P, so there exists A which belongs to I but not is in P. Now consider an arbitrary element B of J, then the product AB is in IJ which is subset of P, that is AB becomes an element of P. Since P satisfies the given condition, so either A belongs to P or B belongs to P. But since A does not belong to P, so it follows that B must be in P. And since we have considered B to be an arbitrary element of J, it follows that every element of J is an element of P also. That is, J becomes a subset of P. Now, we show that for every prime integer P, the ideal PZ is a prime ideal of Z, and conversely. Consider a prime integer P. Then PZ is an ideal of Z. To show that PZ is a prime ideal, consider two integers A, B such that their product AB is in PZ. Then AB is divisible by P, and since P is a prime integer, so it follows that either P divides A or P divides B. Equivalently, either A belongs to PZ or B belongs to PZ. This shows that PZ is a prime ideal. Now, we show that every maximal ideal is a prime ideal. Consider a maximal ideal M of R. To show that M is a prime ideal of R, consider two elements A and B from R such that their product AB is in M. If A belongs to M, then we have done. Assume that A is not in M. Then the ideal generated by M and A properly contains M. Since M is a maximal ideal, so the ideal generated by M A must be equal to R, and hence we have some M in capital M and R in R such that 1 equal to M plus R A. Multiply B to both sides and get B equal to M B plus R A B. Since M belongs to M and A B is also in M, it follows that M B plus R A B is in M, that is, B belongs to M. Thus, we see that the maximal ideal M is also a prime ideal of R. Now, naturally, I have the duty to give an example to show that there are prime ideals which are not maximal. For this, consider the ring R equal to Z cross Z. Then the ideal P of all elements of the form N0 is a prime ideal. But notice that P is a subset, a proper subset of the proper ideal N2M, collection of all elements N2M. This shows that though P is a prime ideal, but it is not maximal ideal because it is properly contained in a proper ideal. So, we see that every maximal ideal is a prime ideal, but there are many prime ideals which are not maximal ideals. Now, we show that quotient by a prime ideal gives us an integral domain. For this, consider a prime ideal P of R. We show that the quotient ring R by P is an integral domain. First, note that since R is a commutative ring with 1, the quotient ring R by P is also a commutative ring with 1. And since here we have assumed P to be a proper ideal, it follows that the unity of the quotient ring R by P is distinct from the zero of the quotient ring. To show that R by P has no zero divisors, consider two elements A plus P and B plus P from the quotient ring R by P such that their product is the zero element of the quotient ring. then it follows that AB plus P equal to 0 plus P, and which implies that AB belongs to P. Since P is a prime ideal, it follows that either A belongs to P or B belongs to P. Equivalently, either A plus P is the 0 or B plus P is the 0. Thus, we see that R by P is a commutative ring with 1, which has no 0 divisors, and hence R by P is an integral domain. Now, we show that if P is a proper ideal such that R by P is an integral domain, then P must be a prime ideal. To show that P is a prime ideal, consider two elements A and B from R such that their product AB is in P. Then we shift ourselves to the quotient ring R by P, because here the given condition is on the quotient ring R by P. So, the equivalence of the condition that AB belongs to P in R is AB plus P is the 0 element of R by P. That is, A plus P into B plus P is the 0 element of R by P. Since the quotient ring R by P has no 0 divisors, so either A plus P is the 0 element or B plus P is the 0 element, and which implies that either A belongs to P or B belongs to P. And so it follows that P is a prime ideal. Now we show that every commutative ring with 1 has a prime ideal. We have seen that every maximal ideal is a prime ideal, and in the last module we have proved that every commutative ring with 1 has a maximal ideal, from which it follows directly that every commutative ring with 1 has a prime ideal. Still, I would like to give here another proof of the existence of prime ideals in every commutative ring with 1. Here, this proof demonstrates a technique which is very useful in the commutative ring theory. Suppose R is a commutative ring with 1. We call a non-empty subset S of R to be a multiplicative subset if 0 does not belong to S, 1 is in S, and for every AB in S, their product AB is also an element of S. Here we actually prove that if S is a multiplicative subset of R and I is an ideal of R which does not meet S, then R has a prime ideal P containing I such that P intersection S is empty. We will prove this result with the help of Jones' lemma. So, first of all, we have to construct a partially ordered set A. Here we consider A to be the set of all proper ideals J of R such that the given ideal I is a subset of J and J intersection S is the empty set. Then the given ideal I is a member of this set A, and hence A is non-empty. Also, A is a partially ordered set with respect to the usual set inclusion relation. Similar to the proof of the theorem that every commutative ring R with 1 has a maximal ideal, here also it can be shown that the set A has a maximal element. We denote this by P, Now we show that this maximal element P is a prime ideal. First note that since P is in A, so I is a subset of P and P intersection S equal to phi. So, it remains to prove only that P is a prime ideal. For this, consider two elements AB in R such that their product is in P. We have to show that either A is in P or B is in P. If possible, on the contrary, assume that neither A nor B is in P. Then P is contained properly in both the ideals generated by P A and P B. Since I is a subset of P and P is a subset of the ideal generated by P union A, so this ideal satisfies the first condition to be a member of A. But since P is properly contained in this ideal and P is a maximal element of A, so it cannot belong to A. And since this ideal is not in A, it follows that intersection of this ideal with S must be non-empty. And similarly, the intersection of the ideal generated by PB and S must be non-empty. Suppose that P1 plus R1A and P2 plus R2B is in S, where P1, P2 are two elements of P and R1, R2 are two elements of R. Since S is multiplicative, product of these two elements is also in S. If we expand the product, then we get P1, P2, which is an element of P, and the next term is R1A P2, since P2 is in P, so the next term is also P, is in P, and the third term is also is in P, and in the fourth term there is a factor AB which is in P, so R1, R2, AB is in P. Thus, this expression is also is in P. So, we see that S intersection P is non-empty, which contradicts that S intersection P is an empty set. Therefore, our assumption that neither A nor B is in P is wrong, and it follows that either A belongs to P or B belongs to P. Thus, P becomes a prime ideal. Thus, we have existence of a prime ideal in every commutative ring with 1. Now, I give a particular example to explore that an ideal apparently same looking may be maximal, may be prime, and even may not be prime depending on the ring of which the set is considered as an ideal. Here, as an example, I consider the ideal generated by X in the polynomial ring Rx. Recall that the ideal generated by X in Rx is the collection of all polynomials of the form X into Fx, where Fx runs over Rx. That is, the collection of all polynomials having zero constant term. Also, we have the quotient ring of Rx determined by the ideal generated by X is isomorphic to R. Our first example shows that if R is a field, then the ideal generated by X is a maximal ideal. Since the quotient ring Rx by ideal generated by X is isomorphic to R, if we take R a field, then it follows that the ideal generated by X is a maximal ideal in Rx. And similarly, it follows that if we consider R to be an integral domain, then the ideal generated by X is a prime ideal. And if we take R to be an integral domain such that it is not a field, say for example Z, then the ideal generated by X is such that it is a prime ideal but not a maximal ideal. Now we show that this ideal generated by X even may not be a prime ideal. Consider the polynomial ring over Z6. Note that Z6 is not an integral domain. In fact, we have two elements, box 2 and box 3 in Z6 whose product is 0. Using this, we construct two polynomials fx and gx as given here. Take their product fx into gx, then this becomes a polynomial which is in the ideal generated by x since its constant term is 0. But notice that the constant term of fx is box 2 which is non-zero, and the constant term of gx which is box 3 non-zero, and hence neither fx nor gx is in ideal generated by x. And it follows that ideal generated by x is not a prime ideal. So, in this chapter we have considered two special kinds of ideals of a commutative ring with unity. One is maximal ideals and the other is prime ideals. We have discussed specially the quotient structure of a commutative ring with unity by maximal ideals and by prime ideals. We have shown that every commutative ring with unity has a maximal ideal, and also proved that every maximal ideal is a prime ideal. But don't forget that there are prime ideals which are not maximal. The proof that every maximal ideal is a prime ideal can be given alternatively using their quotient structure. If M is a maximal ideal, then the quotient ring R by M is a field, and you know that every field is an integral domain, and from which it follows that every maximal ideal M is a prime ideal also. In the radical theory of commutative rings and in algebraic geometry, maximal ideals and prime ideals play central role. The great commutative algebraist Oskar Jariske introduced a topology using prime ideals, which presently known as Jariske topology after his name. In the radical theory, we consider Jacobson radical JR of a commutative ring R as the intersection of all maximal ideals, and prime radical denoted by NR as the intersection of all prime ideals. Equivalently, it can be shown that the prime radical is the collection of all nilpotent elements. These are very interesting and as well as useful topic in commutative ring theory. If you opt commutative ring theory in your next course, you will learn these details in these courses.